Boy, and those kids grow up. They spend a few bucks and collect some of the coolest cars you've ever seen. We asked you to show us your cool cars. Boy, did you ever. Our You Local photo section on KCCI.com has been overflowing.
So our Todd Magel has been getting an amazing look inside some garages of some very lucky Central Iowans. He is back with us tonight, live outside. And Todd?
Oh, my.
Well, if you don't recognize that grill, you don't know about cars. What do you found there, Todd?
Wow.
Would you believe a 1960 Rolls-Royce Silver Cloud? Nice car, eh? This used to belong to the Jewett family here in Des Moines. They bought it from an original Rolls-Royce dealer in Des Moines. It's gone now, but Steve Davis of Des Moines is now taking care of this unbelievably beautiful car. All original, 60 years old, just one of the cool cars we found.
Iowans are passionate about their cars and overwhelmed us with emails, pictures, and stories of their four-wheeled babies. It was hard, but we narrowed down more than 100 cool cars to 8, and here they are. It's been called one of the most beautiful cars in the world. This 1962 Jaguar XKE is the best of the best.
People are just, they run to the car. They don't just stroll over to it. People literally run to the car and just, they can't, they just stand in awe.
Even Randy Anderson is in awe, and he spent the past 10 years restoring every nut and every bolt in his Urbandale garage. Look closely, and you will find absolute perfection.
See, if you were to pick up this car on June 29th, 1962 at the factory is when this car was delivered, it's exactly what you would have picked up. Everything has been refinished, refurbished, repainted, replated to that standard.
Anderson took us for a ride, and it truly looks and feels like a new car. From the $15,000 opalescent gunmetal paint job to the sparkle of the chrome wire wheels, the Jaguar is so clean you could eat off the engine, and that's just the way he likes it. A lot of work.
But looking at the result is just phenomenal. We go and riding on the freeway,
all alone in my pink Cadillac. From perfection to a pampered original, it's a 1976 Cadillac Fleetwood Brougham. Owner Jerome Haynes let me drive his 20-foot-long Pride and Joy in West Des Moines.
So what'd you think about it when you saw it?
Oh, my eyes fell out. I said, man, that car lasts forever.
Haynes says just about everything on the car is just like it was back in the 1970s. And the old license plates give a clue about the Caddy's history. It used to belong to former Governor Terry Branstad's mother. There's so much room in the back seat, there's space for fold-down footrests. Haynes bought the car about a year and a half ago and drives it, white vinyl roof and all, sparingly.
Just to the Cadillac dealer, just to go get a free car wash, show it off, and drive it on Sunday to church, and just only put 35 to 50 miles on it a month.
By 1965, the Ford Thunderbird was already a cool car, and Bill Jackson's poppy red convertible is still one of the coolest.
I don't think I've ever stopped at a stop sign where someone hasn't said, what year is that? Great car. Give me the thumbs up. It's one of the first tilt wheels.
The tilt wheel doesn't move up and down. It swings sideways. And the convertible top tucks under an hydraulic folding trunk lid that is as much fun to watch as the car is to drive. Like most classic car owners, Jackson lusted after his favorite car when he was a college kid. Now, he can afford to drive his dream.
It's a lot of fun.
It's also a lot of fun to start a Ford Model T. There's no key. In fact, there are a few familiar controls when you take the wheel of this 1917 Jewel.
I take better care of this than my newer cars, probably.
Jerry Rorta's Model T is one of 15 million made between 1909 and 1927, but it may be one of the few that remains in the same family. Rorta's grandfather bought it new near Pella 92 years ago. After some years of tough farm work, the T was restored in the 1970s by Rorta's father, and it looks brand new.